whichever one y'all want to call me. And today is a story time, and I'm going to talk about my oldest brother in this video. Now, my oldest brother was like me growing up watching him. Everybody in the neighborhood knew my big brother TJ. He was very athletic. He was like 6'6" or something like that. He just played basketball a lot, and everybody just knew him. And I remember just watching him like do backflips in the fields and stuff like that, and like just thinking like my brother, he was a really, really, really big dude. Like, not fat wise, but like muscle bound kind of wise. Like, he was big. And just remember him doing like backflips and running and stuff, just being very athletic. And yeah, just watch him do all that stuff and trying to like do what he does. But I was a little small kid, I couldn't do all that stuff, still can't. I wasn't very athletic, but I am sort of athletic now, but not very. But my brother was very athletic. So this is someone who I watched grow up. Like, while I was growing up, I was watching him and just watching him go to the courts, different basketball courts, and play basketball and hoop dudes out. I wanted to be like in basketball. I wanted to be like my brother and stuff like that. So growing up, I thought he was invincible. Like, I didn't think anybody can do any harm to him. No one can beat him or nothing like that, because of the way he was. He's a very cool dude, always smiling and stuff. So yeah, but as I got older and stuff, like probably into my, I would say, started getting like 12, 13, stuff like that, I started to see my brother change. And I don't know, it could have been like he has a different dad than like the rest of my mom's kids. Well, and stuff like that. It's another story. I have a different dad, but I never met his dad. I wasn't even thought about, but his dad got killed. And so I believe stuff like that can probably traumatized him, and then it didn't take effect until later on. So I just started to see him deteriorate, like in his mind. It started off very, very slow. Cause I remember he worked at McDonald's and he had this little hatchback car. And that wasn't the first car line I drive, no. But I remember that car. And I remember him not working at McDonald's anymore and just saying something changed. Hearing like things were different about him. And like, I just watched this over the years, him just changing, being like very, very to himself and stuff like that. Then I started to notice him just like talking to himself or just laughing out of the blue on nothing and stuff like that. So my mom took him to a mental health center. They diagnosed him with a mental illness, schizophrenia. He was on medication, so we tried to we didn't think he was suicidal or anything, but we still just watched him more often, you know. And but he can still function. Like, if he wanted to go and get a job, he would just have to be on this medication and stuff, so he doesn't wig out or anything. But eventually, eventually, you know, people get tired of medications, and I just think he started to suffer more and more in his mind when I got like around like I'd say 16, 17, 18, around that age. I just felt like he started to suffer more. So one day he took all his medication, like he took all the pills, swallowed them all, but they weren't going to kill him. But that was his first attempt at suicide. And so he did that, and then, you know, he took to the hospital and all that, and then he had to go to this place for people with severe, like, mental illness and stuff. I think he had to stay there for about 2-3 months, something like that. And, you know, it was just only me and my mom that had visited him there. And, you know, we were just in, like, he was in all white. We was in his, like, eating room. And, he was just there. He didn't talk a lot or anything, you know. But, so after that, he was let go from there. Because I guess they did all the treatment that they can do for him and whatnot. And, he was okay. Like, not like okay, like when I was a kid, okay, but he was okay, you know. And so he was still just suffering in the head, and there was really nothing we could do but give him this medication. So now he's diagnosed with schizophrenia, and they say he's suicidal, and we, you know, there's more medications and stuff. So now, we're trying to watch him very closely and stuff, for real. You know, I really watch him, try to make sure that he's taken care of. Shirt like this color red, probably a little darker. I'm in my mom's room, and he's walking by me, but I didn't know he was going to the room. Cause my room was right here, then the bathroom right down. I already went in my mom's room before I seen which way he went. I'm not thinking anything of it, okay? So I'm in my mom's room. Now my room is right here. My mom's room's right here, okay? I'm in my mom's room. I don't remember what she was saying to me, but she was talking to me. And so, next thing I know, I'm getting ready to leave my mom's room. I see like a red flash, just like it's just like that by me. And I haven't made it out to my mom's room door. Not paying attention. So I go back in my room, lay down, listening to the music. And I turned it down a little bit for some reason. And I can look from my room to the living room and see who's in the living room, because it's like a hall, then my room, hallway, all the way to the living room. I can see straight like that. And I look up and I'm looking at my mom. She's just sweeping in the living room. So, next thing I know, while I'm looking at my mom, I hear, bah! It's a gunshot. Everybody gets down. My mom's like, what's that? And whatnot. So, like I said, another day in the hood, we just thought somebody was out there being stupid shooting. We didn't think nothing of it at all whatsoever. We thought nothing of it because we live in the ghetto. We didn't think nothing of it. They do it all the time. So, after about 5-10 minutes go by, my mom says, where's TJ? So, they say probably walking, because my brother used to walk around the neighborhood all day long, you know. He'll walk, he used to come in the house like 3, 4, 5 in the morning, just walking around, you know. So, my mom says, where's TJ? Someone was like, probably just walking around. And so, I'm off my bed now in the living room. And, me and my little sister go outside. And a family friend was walking down the street. And we say, you saw TJ? Because this family friend, he walks around to the neighborhood. He's not crazy or anything, but like he just walks around the neighborhood a lot too. We say, you seen TJ? And he says, he walks up a little bit and he gets in our driveway, and then he walks to the back of the house and he says he back here asleep. And we like, me and my sister look at each other like, sleep. So we walk back there, we hear him like snoring. And my sister shines her phone on him and she reaches his head and she jumps up and screams and throws the phone because he has a bullet hole in his brain. And we run in the house, tell my mom, and you know, she goes out there, she sees it, and she's, you know, breaks down crying and runs off back to the house. So we call the police, paramedics, ambulance, and all them people arrive, and you know, it's a big crowd in front of our house. People don't know what's going on. And we're all just on the porch, just crying our eyes out. And, you know, they put my brother on a stretcher. They're getting my little brother's name and information because he told him it was his gun. see my brother, and I couldn't make it to the room where he was because I had already seen him on the ground. I didn't want to see him with tubes or anything. Getting his throat, that's like nose stuff like that. So I didn't go back there and look at him, but you know, they told us if they could have saved him, he would have been like a vegetable. The bullet had went in his brain, and it went bounced around his skull, and it turned his brain to like mush. Anxieties and things like that, just get some help. I will post some numbers that you can call to talk to somebody, because I love my brother at the end of the day. Him doing that hurting just himself hurt it. Streets, like, just, you know, just had their hands up because my brother was loved in my neighborhood. Everybody knew my brother. If you feel like you want to do something to yourself, please. Yourself, you hurt everybody else, so please just seek help, please. Just thank you guys for watching again. Thank you for listening. Please get help if you know somebody who's going through this.